Hello everyone, this is Rob from eMotion Repairs, and today I'm going to be replacing the key switch unit on a Kugoo G-Booster. Now, this one's in a bit of a state of mid-repair at the moment, so there are two ways of doing this. If you don't have a soldering iron, you can actually use these to replace the connections that go into this plug. However, if you are good at soldering, you can cut these wires and solder them to the existing side. This connector connects to the rear speed controller, and it connects from the key switch side to the controller side, red to orange, black to black, and green to red. There are a number of ways of doing this, but if you disconnect that connector, you can actually liberate the pins. I need light. That's how I do it. You can liberate the pins from inside the plastic connector and put the new pins in their place. Be sure to get the order correct, because else things could go wrong very badly. Like I say, there are two ways of doing this. If you get the whole mechanism and you don't have a soldering iron and solder, or don't feel confident using it, then you would remove the handlebars, the switches, the brake lever, and then release the grub screw on the back of the key switch unit, and then take it off. You'd also need to liberate those wires from the plastic connector, obviously taking note of which way up this connector is and where the wires go. Undo the loom and bring it all the way up and out here, because you may notice from the back of the key switch, it does not go into this big block connector here. It has its own separate wire. So you'd have to run that all the way down. But even though I've got most of the spiral undone, I'm not going to do it that way. I'm going to show you a quicker way of doing this if you're confident using a soldering iron and replace just the key switch unit and leaving the rest of this in place. First of all, you'll need to remove the hand grip. That is simple enough as just pulling on it. Due to the way things are in the way of other things, I'm going to have to remove the switches first, which is this mechanism here. Then I can get to that nut here, so that that bolt here, so I can loosen this. And then you'll need a hex head or Allen key of 2.5 millimeters in size to loosen off the key mechanism. To remove the handlebar grip, you just need to pull on it. It's easier just pulling it from this side rather than from the end out. And to remove the switch mechanisms, there is a bolt at the back. It is the 3 millimeter hexagonal tip or Allen key. And to remove the brake lever, you'll need the 5 mil hex tip or Allen key. Once you've removed the everything off the bar, you can slide it out to the side, and the cable might not give you enough length to slide it out all the way, but the most important thing is that you can access this very easily. After all, we don't need to remove it from the handlebars. In fact, in this case, it might be helpful that it stays on the handlebars while I do the soldering at the back of this switch. Now, one of the first things you'll need to do is remove this. This is done by a small turn anti-clockwise, and to make life easy, I use my 2.5 mil Allen key in there and then help it round. From that point, you can pick out the plastic bit so that you've liberated the inside. Again, this is just really a matter of convenience. It's not essential, but it does help. Once you've done that, remove the screws here, here, and here, and remove this plastic cover. There are a couple of little clips. There's one up here, one down there, and one at the back. So just remember, it does unclip. They just need to pop out, and there you go. I've done that one-handed whilst recording. Now, what we're going to do, we're going to remove the lock mechanism here by unsoldering two red wires that go to one side and the green wire that goes to the other side. And it doesn't really matter which order these go on, as long as you have two red on one side and the one green on the other side. As you can see off camera, I've already gone ahead and removed the screws and the plastic bit from the lock, the new plate replacement part, which has the keys here. I will also be, just take that out, removing the green wire and the two red wires from this lock, as the keys only fit this lock mechanism. Just a tip, but when you've removed the lock from the scooter, it's a good idea to twist these two red wires together so that when you're soldering it back on, you're not having to deal with them pulling apart from each other. When you've done your soldering, it's a good idea to check that both of these are firmly attached, because scooters do vibrate quite a bit, so you want to make sure that your soldering is good. When you put the lock mechanism back up into its holder, you want to make sure that this lip here goes up into this little cutout here, and that will make sure that when you're turning the key, it doesn't wobble the whole mechanism around. So if I can just show you here, that will go up like that, and when the plastic bit there goes back on, that will hold it in place. Also, you'll want to make sure that the wires come out and go into the back part of the thing and just follow out this area here. Once you've got the plastic cover back on, just check that this doesn't wobble around inside the case. It doesn't, so I've got that bit correct. Just go ahead and replace the screws here, here, and here. Once you've got all three screws in, reattach this disc. Now, near the holes on the outside, there are these little clips, and they only do up in one direction, and they clip on to these bits. So from the top, make sure that the clip from this side is to the left of that. Push it all the way on. I won't be able to do this one-handed and holding the camera, but push it all the way in so it's flush, and then drive it round that way. If you're struggling to do so, use your 2.5mm bit or Allen key to push inside that hole to help you get it clipped into place. Once the plastic ring is back on and clipped into place nice and securely, just check that it isn't loose. Just try and pick away at it from a few different angles to make sure that it's on place. And if it is, go ahead and reattach everything pretty much in the reverse order of how I got you to remove them. Go ahead and tighten up the grubs that hold on the lock mechanism and the switches, and after that you want to get this correct. I recommend stand over your scooter, put your hands on the handlebars and feel it out. So if you don't feel right, raise it up or lower it down, however you choose, and then you can do the grub screw up. It's that one there. Just do that up and that's pretty much done. Now, I haven't done that up yet, but I'm just gonna skip ahead so I don't waste your time. I've already gone ahead and connected the battery to the rear controller. So, put the key in, turn it on, and we get a voltage reading. There you go. I'm gonna leave this plastic film on the display here, and that's up to the customer. He can have the lovely privilege of removing that. And that is now job done. I've tightened this up and it's about right. I don't know how tall this customer is, so I based it on the same angle as the other side. Everything's in place, nothing's loose, his accessories are still there, and this is job done. But this is a simpler, probably faster way of doing it than running the old cable up and the new cable down and into the controller and all that lot. It's just quicker in this instance for me to do it like this most of the time. I probably wouldn't have saved much time given that most of the cables on this rather busted G-Booster, it probably wouldn't have taken me too long to unspiral that and run it, but I just wanted to show everyone there is a faster way of doing this and it works just great. My name's Rob from eMotion Repairs. Hope you fix your booster.